So would you sort of say that in psychodynamic, in the psychodynamic approach, we look at sort of non-heteronormativity as something that needs to be changed and again brought back to the supposed norm?
It's like blind men guiding a blind man. Okay, I can, but then you reflect, you will give a deeper answer.
I'm not sure I understand the question.
Yeah. If I got it correctly, I think that it's not really direct answer to your question, but more the background, that one big lesson from, still actual from Freud, and I wonder if you would agree, is that we should drop this topic popular from 60s sexual revolution, that sexuality is some kind of free reservoir, unconscious, then oppressed by violent normativity, norms, and so on. Today, I think that's why we get all this self-sabotage, guilt feelings, and so on. You know, the problem is not, as neoconservatives claim, that we are just wild hedonists, we don't have norms. We have unconscious norms, may be stronger than ever. The pathology today is almost the opposite of the classical one. It's, I feel free, consumerist, I do orgies, whatever. But then my unconscious can be very conservative, some hidden, oppressed norms, and so on and so on. So that don't simply identify the unconscious with some liberating energy that has to be set free, and so on and so on. Again, this is for me a much more interesting theoretically, practically, politically situation where, you know, you penetrate a little bit deeper into the unconscious, you don't get some free-floating energy. You get extremely oppressive norms, and so on and so on. And that's maybe what is one of the possible readings of today's neoconservatives and so on, although I think that there the situation is much more paradoxical. Like, take, you mentioned the guy, I didn't pronounce this obscene name, Donald Trump, you know. Just imagine the paradox, a guy who flirts at least with neocons, moral revival, it's obviously an extremely obscene, lewd, perverted guy, and so on and so on. Now, how can this happen? The official version is, and there is some truth to it, that conservative Americans, true fundamentalists, they know how Trump is. And I often in debate with them, some stupid public debate, got this answer. Don't mention Trump's private life. We know what he is. But nonetheless, he promised certain things like limiting abortion and so on and so on. And that's what really interests us. We are ready to talk. But I think this is a way too simple explanation. I think that in a way, they identify precisely with this Trump's hypocritical inconsistency, you know. You pretend to be ethical neocon, but you are really an obscene guy, and so on and so on. This is because this is the big tragedy with Trump. The more he is caught with his pants down, you know, like saying something stupid, obscene, instead of ruining him, it almost helps him, you know. Here, psychoanalysis is needed. Here you can see how the process of identification is much more subtle. What if you don't identify with the ideal image of a person, but precisely with what you perceive as the dirty, hidden, private side, and so on, and so on, and so on. So, with considering a normativity, if you mean any type of sexual normativity, and so on, I don't think that an authentic psychoanalysis is doing it, in the sense that you presuppose a certain model, and so on, and so on. We just, again, psychoanalysis would tell us this. First, that especially to be attentive to hidden normativity precisely from those who pretend to fight against normativity and so on and so on. For example, many gay theorists, and they admitted this to me, just propose a different normativity, that gay people have a normative superiority over us who conceded to patriarchal ruling ideology. So for them, it's not just we have the right to be gay, but in their reconstruction of psychic process, of how subjectivity emerges, there is, if I may put it in these terms, some ontological even priority of being gay. Something is visible there in sexuality which gets oppressed in normal heterosexuality. So that would be my basic answer. Look for normativity, especially with those who claim, oh, we are just violating norms and no. Just an important point, it came to me now with getting old senile, belated, about that question about normativity. You know where things go really interesting? You think in many communities, departments, classes, school classes and so on, there is a certain explicit normativity. But when you get to know that circle, you discover that there is a deeper normativity which tells you how to violate and in what way some explicit norms. Like there are departments where to be university, where to be really accepted, you have to violate certain rules, make fun of certain professors and so on. And that's what interests me so much, how the very violation of norms is regulated by another deeper level of normativity. That's it.